Hi, so today I'm here with little Miss Posey, and we are going to attempt to make our very own car seat. It's going to be a center console car seat that fits between the two passenger seats. Some of the supplies I'll be using are a tape measure, a piece of foam to use as a cushion and to lift her up a little higher inside of her car seat. I happen to have this foam at home. I bought it at Joann's with a 40 or 50% off coupon a while back, so it wasn't too expensive, and I just never used it for the original project, so today I'll be using it. And also, we are using this little plastic container here, which was just something we've had around the house as well. And we are going to use an electric meat cutter, because I think that'll saw through it pretty well. I've seen somebody else do that. Posey! And little Miss Posey is going to be my helper. Yes, she is. So, let's get started. First off, this foam is about 17 inches across, so I am marking at the 8.5 inch mark so that I can cut it directly down the center to stack it up on top of each other when we put it inside of the container to give it some extra height and comfort. Okay, so I didn't film it because I didn't have enough hands, but I went ahead and took the meat slicer and went right down the top of these and was able to cut it in like a matter of seconds. Pretty straight. So now I will take them and put them inside of here. So I ended up only putting one piece of foam in the container. It leaves about, I don't know, 5 inches of depth. Okay, so next I'm going to take some batting that I had already, and I went ahead and doubled mine over and then hot glued it so that it'll be a little thicker, and I'm going to actually just hot glue it onto the base, or not the base, but the top rim of my tub. So now I'm applying glue all over, hot glue, to the back of my batting, especially on the edge and the middle. And then, it is hot, so be careful. Just go ahead and stick it on down to the rim of the plastic. Add a little more glue where you see needed. Okay, next you'll want to take some measuring tape and take it around the widest point of your container. Mine is measuring about 52 inches, and you'll want to add about an inch to that when you're writing down your measurements. You'll also want to measure the depth. I'm going to measure mine from the point of the foam insert because this is going to determine how deep our fabric needs to go inside. So I've got about 4.5 inches this way, but I'm going to go all the way over to the base and add maybe about 3 inches because I want it to go around the bottom with elastic to stay on. So I'm going with 14 inches there. And these measurements will help us to sew our slipcover. Okay, so here's what I did. I took some fabric, and I did purchase this. I wanted that faux lamb's wool fabric, and I knew that around my container, it was 52 inches, and I was going to add about an inch for seam allowance. So I went ahead and measured that. I had to use more than one piece, so I went ahead and did that with another piece. And once I cut them out and I decided what the depth I needed was, I cut my strip and I went ahead and sewed those together until I had one long running strip. And this is what that looked like, one long running strip. Now I decided that I wanted to add denim or another material as well. So I went ahead and sewed that all the way around the base of it. So I took my long wool piece, took the denim material, and I took the good sides, and I put them up to each other like this, and sewed it all the way down my strip until my strip was half sheep and half denim, and it was a long 53 inches long. And once I got that all the way together, I took both ends and put them good side together and sewed them together so it's one continuous loop. Next, I take my container and I measure across this way 9 inches and across this way 14 inches. I add about half an inch to each of those, and I go ahead and take my lamb's wool and cut out a rectangular shape to those dimensions. Now this piece I will take and sew, connecting it to my denim and lamb's wool fabric that I have already made a continuous loop, and I will show you how to do that. Now to get the fabric rectangular shape for the base to attach to our liner, I went ahead and put my circular liner that I've already sewn the strips together and stick it around my container, making sure that the center the seam that I connected the pieces of fabric with ends up on one of the corners of my tub, like so. Get it all the way across. And of course, yours doesn't have to be the two-toned. It can just be one continuous piece of fabric. Just make sure that it's lined up with my corner, which it's not. So I'm going to pull it up a little bit and try again. So that seam is matched up with the corner. Come around. And if you notice, I actually have two corner seams because I ended up having to use two strips of fabric which were connected and then connected at the end, remember? Okay, so my corners are there. So then I would take my square piece my rectangular piece that I cut out, fit it in here. It should fit perfectly because we measured. Take a pin. I find one of the corner seams. I pick up the very base of the fabric down here and the corner of my rectangle and pin it in. Now I have my fabric the wrong way. Your fabric should be inside out, okay? So the back side of the wool, Take your base, the corner of this material, the corner of this material, take your pin and go ahead and mark your corners. Do all four corners. And when you're done with that, you can go ahead and take the slip cover off now that your four corners are connected to the corners of the circular tube. Now take as many pins as you need to match. You've already got your corners all done, so I've gone along and I'm connecting this to the base. And I'm going around with the two pieces of fabric and connecting them so it'll make it easier when I go to sew them together. And you might feel like the fabric from the circular tube is a little bunchy, but you just kind of even it out as best you can. At this point, I would come to my sewing machine. Turn it on. Making sure not to get all this extra fabric in the way, keeping it out, and just doing a 1/4 inch seam allowance. Taking out the corner pin, putting it away, sticking here, and I would sew down the length till I get to this corner, and pivoting and turning and always continuing to keep this extra fabric out of the way until I have completed a square. Excuse me, rectangle. Okay, so as you can see, the rectangular base has been connected to the tube of fabric, and now I have what looks like a bag. almost like a shopping bag. Okay, so now we can take this and our container, which we have our foam in, batting around the sides. Take this slip cover we just made. I use one of my corner seams, and we're gonna have the back side going down and over. I match one of the corner seams up here, and I want my lamb's wool to come over the edge somewhat. This corner here where I have a seam is gonna line up as well. Fit it in there, it should fit just right. You can just kind of see where your seam is on this square piece, so you want that down at the base of your foam. To see if it's fitting correctly. I'm pretty happy with the way mine's fitting. It's soft around here, so it'll be comfortable for the dog. It's soft at the base. And so, my next step would be the bottom. I probably have way too much fabric here, but I do need to have a little extra where I can actually hide the elastic inside of. And so I want there to be elastic in the base of this so I can slip it on and it'll stay snug around the base of the car seat. So that's another step we need to work on. I've also bought two buckles and some nylon strapping, which are going to create the buckles that will come into the base of my tub here and go underneath the foam and strap around the center console compartment of my car, which will keep the car seat secure. And the way I plan on doing this is, because this is plastic, I will get a hot metal skewer that I have, and I've done this with other plastic containers that I needed to make a slit in, but warmed it up over heat and then just kind of sliced a 1 inch, probably a tiny bit wider than 1 inch, section here, here, and on the opposite sides, so I can strap, so I can string through this nylon strapping and then attach the buckles to it. So I am going to take my foam out. I've just heated the edge of the skewer, and I think I want it about here, so I'm going to use a little pressure. It's gone through, and just do kind of a sawing motion to the side and twisting it. That's given me somewhat of a hole, but we need it to go an inch, a little over an inch, so I'm going to reheat. I'm going to add some length to this. Getting there. And again. Oops. Make sure those edges are smooth. You can run this along the length. Okay, and I think that's the perfect length. So I'll continue that 3 more times. Okay, I've completed that. I've put the holes on both sides, 2 on each side, so that the strap can be strung through and around, and it'll clamp down here around the base, well, the lid of the car console. So, looking pretty good. At this point, you'll want to check and make sure that your nylon strapping will fit through all of the holes that you've made. Make sure they're wide enough, and mine are. So next, I'm going to take the buckles that I bought and sew the straps on. So you just string the nylon strap through here, leave a little bit of room so you can fit it underneath, beneath the sewing foot. And get the pedal under your foot. And of course I did something weird. There we go. And I'm going back and forth a couple of times to make sure it's nice and secure. And do it on the outer edge as well. You could try to do a square, but I am trying to get mine as close as I can so my pedal gets in the way. And then an X through the center for added strength. And one across the other side. Trim those off. And sew one more this way. Back and forth. And that's it. So now I'm going to take a portion of an old dog leash that I have. I've cut it off. I've determined how much I want to allow the dog to move around inside the car carrier, and I'm going to just take the end of it here and sew a little loop so that it'll fit over this strap, which will be inside of the car seat and buckled at the end so that it'll secure it in. Okay, so now that I've sewn a loop in here and I've gone zigzag over it several times so it's very secure, you can thread it through your strap. So once the strap is wrapped around the base of the car seat and snapped into the center console, this will come up, extending past the foam and through the material, and latch onto the dog's car seat. Okay, so here's the car seat. I'm stringing the nylon strap through the base and through the other side, and this is where I'll put the other end of the strap on. But before I bring it through the second hole, I want to leave it up in the center. Take this new little strap that I made out of an old leash, put that on, and then take the nylon strap and band it through. So this is now secure in here. Now I'll take my foam that we had cut before and place this down inside. This is still here. This is all underneath the here. And we'll attach the other ends of the buckles to this. Okay, so now I'll take the other end of the buckle, which you just string it through here, and then back up around here, and you can adjust it, and it's secure. You can go smaller or tighter. So now on our slip cover that we made, I went ahead and put a buttonhole, a very large one, I kind of made one, in the corner so the leash can come up out of. And I also went ahead and made a little spot to put my elastic through. So what I did was I took my denim and let's find a straight edge. I went ahead and made a small little fold and went all the way around the length, all the way down, all the way around the whole loop, the whole circle. And then after that, I took it back and I folded again, making sure that I have enough room for my elastic to fit through this little slip. And so then, and not too big, but not too small. And so this is the second time over, all the way around the whole loop. So at this point, after I've sewn all the way around, which I have on mine, but I've left an opening the second time around, so I can take my elastic, which I put onto a safety pin, and I can start slipping it through here, and I hold the safety pin because I can feel it, and I can bunch up the fabric and pull it through. Okay, so I've gone ahead and strung the elastic all the way through and came where my opening was, and I just took the two and knotted them together, as you can see here, instead of sewing them, because as I started looking at it, I think I just have too much length, let me back up here, on my fabric. So I want to maybe go back in and cut a little bit off and remake my little slip where I can stick in my elastic. So for now, I'm going to let it be, though, because we are going on a trip tomorrow morning, and it is already evening, so I need to wrap this project up. It took me a couple of days because I had to stop here and there. As you can see, the buckles are on the bottom. When you flip it over, this is what it looks like. We have the strap here. And I'll go strap it in the car and give you a final look. Okay, so we're here in the car. I've opened up the little center console compartment between the two two front seats. And underneath here, I've strapped both buckles, and I'll go ahead and tighten them as well and get them real secure. At that point, we'll pull it shut. So I've tightened the straps really tight and secure. You'll want to make sure your buckles are in the center and the straps are in. And then you can tuck those in and go ahead and bring this down and latch it. And, sorry, that was a little bright. There we go. It's in there. Totally secure. Then your pooch will sit up in here and you'll buckle her in and hit the road. This way they can see out. They're right next to you, but they're not able to jump out or harm themselves. They're strapped in. Hope this helped.